Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to play new game, Hogwarts Legacy. Are you ready? Let's get started. So, start game. Boom! Oh, okay. Okay, let's see. I like her. Male, female. Let's see. Mm-hmm. Oh, even she is cute a little bit. Okay. All right. Not bad. Yeah. Oh, here more. So, which face I want? Oh, here. Yeah, pretty cute face. Yeah, maybe. Do I look like a man? Yeah, even this one. Or this one. Okay, I like this one. Skin color. Okay. Let's see. Cute. Okay. Okay, like this. Glasses. Let's see. No, no glasses. Okay, what is this hairstyle? Why don't they just show me the what that is? Okay, hairstyle. Wow, very cute. Okay, I like this hair. Let's see what else. Bang hair. Yeah, I like that one too. Yeah, even this one too. Oh, I like this one too. Oh, more. Okay. Oh, it's cool. I like. Oh. Or this. Or I don't know. Yeah, I like this one. What is the kind of scar? Okay, where is this? Yeah? Freckles. Okay, without. Okay, no scars or markings. Let's see. Oh, looks like badass. Okay, I'm gonna say no. This eye color. Yo, it's beautiful. Wow. Purple. Oh, I like this one. Okay. I want that. Eyebrows color. Hold on, what's this? Oh, where's the hair color? No. Oh, here. Oh, this is skin color. Oh, here. How could I miss this? Okay, nope. No. No. which one's gonna be good for her. Yeah? Yeah, something like that's good. What else? Where were we? Here? Eyebrows? Okay, here. Has to be matched with my hair color. Oh, yeah, this one. And eyebrows. Yeah, I like this one, just plain one. Let's see next. Voice. Okay, here, first.
It was wonderful. I believe I'm really going to enjoy this class. I am indeed a student, but I could very well be able to help you. A few cobwebs and some dust. Nothing to be concerned about.
That was quite something.
It was wonderful. I believe I'm really going to enjoy this class. I'm eager to get to Hogsmeade.
Yeah, maybe I like this voice. So, difficulty, normal, yes. Oh, name. Ooh, hold on a second. Name should be... Hold on. Should we? My last name? I don't know. Okay. Then Dimitri. Which? Wizard. Maybe wizard. Okay. Okay, too boring. Just gonna say fox. Okay, start. Boom.
Ah, it appears we are almost ready to depart. It's a pity we didn't have a bit more time to spend on spellcasting. I presume you've been practicing the spells we worked on.
I have, Professor.
Well, I'm quite sure I've never seen anyone take so quickly to a second-hand wand. You'll be a force to be reckoned with when you get your own.
Thank you, Professor Fig. I appreciate you working with me before the term begins.
Eleazar!
George, glad my rather cryptic description of our location did not thwart your finding us.
I've apparated to more vaguely defined destinations than this. Though I confess I may have miscalculated slightly on my first try. Gave quite the fright to some theatergoers in the West End.
It's been much too long. When I received your owl, I must say I...
Best not speak here, Eleazar.
Of course. Why don't we speak en route to Hogwarts? We have a start of term feast and a sorting ceremony to get to.
Wonderful idea! As long as your young charge here doesn't mind me tagging along.
Not at all, sir.
After you.
Ages since I've been to the castle. Would be good to see the old pile of rocks.
He saw something? Yo, there's no horse. There's no horses. Wow. Oh. Who is that? Yo.
I caught you before you left for Scotland.
Just barely.
And who is your traveling companion?
A new student.
New?
Yes, sir. I'm starting school as a fifth year.
How extraordinary. It is indeed. None of the faculty has ever heard of anyone being admitted to Hogwarts so late.
Nor have I.
Of course, as the other fifth years will have been honing their magical skills for 4 years now, the headmaster asked if I could get our new student up to speed a bit before the term begins.
Well, you couldn't have asked for a better mentor. Professor Fig is not only an exceptional teacher, he's also a remarkably intuitive and gifted wizard.
Mr. Osric is prone to flattery. I dare say it's one of the reasons he's risen so far at the ministry.
Have you seen this?
Wow. Look at this newspaper.
I have. Opinions differ as to how great a threat Ranrok really is.
Although I've yet to convince my colleagues at the ministry, I believe he is a significant threat. And it was your wife, Eleazar, who alerted me to his activities months ago.
Miriam? How?
She wrote to me about Ranrok before she died, wondering what the ministry knew about his activities. Before I could respond, I received this. It was the last thing she sent me, Eleazar. It came to me via her owl, but with no correspondence. I can only assume
that she had to get rid of it quickly to keep it safe.
Presumably from Ranrok. I cannot open it. Aww. Whatever magic protects this is powerful indeed.
Aww. It looks like goblin metal. Aww. That symbol.
What's that glow?
I don't see a glow.
Yeah.
Nor do I.
There's no. Maybe she has something special. Whoa. Yeah, it is.
Merlin's beard. How did you...
Wait.
A key.
We do.
Hang on!
Is that my character?
Yeah! Yeah!
Oh! So close.
Are you all right? You're hurt.
Perhaps a bit.
Take this. It's Wiganweld potion. That stuff will right you in a second.
Heal? Oh, okay.
What happened?
Poor George. I can't believe he... What the hell got into that damn thing? Attacking a carriage mid-air? A typical dragon would never...
Professor? Sir, where are we?
I'm not sure. But that key you discovered was clearly a port key.
Port key?
An item enchanted to bring whoever touches it to a specific place.
So?
I'm feeling better, sir, if you'd like to look around a bit.
I would. But stay close.
Yes,
we've no idea who created this port key. Or why.
Hold on a second. Oh, here. Okay, let's see. Maybe this is sound? Oh. Voice too much, a little bit louder. No, I can't. No. I see.
Take us
farther from London than the carriage traveled. We're somewhere in the Scottish Highlands,
sir. Those ruins, do you think
the port key was meant to lead us there?
I do.
This has not been the day either of us expected, but Miriam sent that port key to George for a reason, and I believe that she, and now George, died in pursuit of whatever it was meant to lead to. If you're sure you're all right, and wouldn't mind indulging me, I'd like to have a look around.
Absolutely, sir.
Good. Let's see if we can find a path, however faded it may be.
Let's go.
Mind your step.
Where do you suppose your wife got the portkey that brought us here?
A good question. Miriam spent years searching for evidence of a long-forgotten form of ancient magic.
Ancient magic?
Yes. A powerful magic wielded by a rare few that seems to have been lost to time. Hogwarts Castle was built by, and is itself a stronghold of, that ancient magic. I don't know where she came into possession of the portkey, but I am certain it was to do with that search. Ah, there's the path down below. This way.
Here?
But sir, why was your wife searching for evidence of lost magic?
Miriam wanted to understand why such powerful magic disappeared from the wizarding world. Spoke of the good it could do. But magic is no different than any power. What really matters is the one who wields it.
Mm-hmm. Is that ice?
It's not cold enough here. It appears to be a sort of enchantment. Someone wanted to block this path. Let's see some of that wand work you were practicing. Focus on the center.
Center? RT. Oh. Whoa.
Excellent.
Excellent. Mm-hmm. Oh, really? I have to search in facing. Okay. Ouch. That's painful.
That was a bit rougher than I'd expected. Your wand work's improving with every cast.
Thank you, sir.
Ah, up there.
Sir, hold on a second. Oh, it's nothing. Oh! Chest. 40.
We're close now. It's just ahead.
Yes, sir.
Steady yourself! Reparo!
Why would someone have built this here?
I suspect they valued their privacy. That portkey led us here for a reason.
Let's have a look around for anything that seems out of place.
All right, sir. Oh, nice. Here. Investigate.
Professor, it's a mural of some kind.
Perhaps our host was a noted seer. Interesting.
Done? Okay, 33. How? Okay, can't go this way.
Professor, this statue...
This may have been his home.
Okay. Oh, there.
That enchanted crystallized stone again. But what could it be blocking?
Really? Let's see.
What's this?
Professor Fig!
No? So? Oh, he's coming.
How odd. Why would someone have conjured that enchanted stone here?
And how is there a room behind it?
What room? I don't see anything.
Really?
There's that glow again, like the glow on the portkey container.
What in Merlin's name?
Oh.
Godric's heart.
What did you say?
Where are we?
I don't believe it.
Godric? Sleeping? Hello, sir.
Hello?
Banker. Excuse me.
It can't be.
The nails.
Just a moment. where are we here?
Welcome to Gringotts Wizarding Bank. Vault number 12, I presume.
Oh?
Precisely.
How could he know?
The key?
Mm?
Uh-huh.
Your wife's portkey.
Oh, yes, of course.
This way, then.
Stay close.
After you. Inside the cart, if you don't wish to lose them.
How many vaults are there in Gringotts?
Hundreds. In fact, you'll see quite a few on our way to vault number 12. As we speak, we're just beneath the main lobby.
Wow.
The vaults you see now are the newest.
Are private entrances to the bank common at Gringotts?
They are most uncommon. Only one with great wealth or power, or both, could have arranged for such a service.
Interesting.
You'll want to take a breath.
A what? That waterfall washes away all enchantments. It's a security measure.
Experienced the thief's downfall before, have you?
Heard of it?
These are the lower vaults that we're passing now.
How deep are we going?
Vault number 12 was commissioned shortly after Gringotts was founded over 4 centuries ago. It resides in the deepest part of the bank. Settle in. We've quite a distance to go.
Vault number?
Vault 12. Momentous day!
On your way.
Professor, The armband that guard was wearing was glowing.
Like the glow you saw on the porky container?
No, darker. I saw that same glow on the dragon's collar.
Yeah, what was that?
We were just wondering about that goblin back there.
He watches over the oldest section of the bank.
What does that mean?
Rare anyone goes there anymore.
Something like that?
Here we are.
Good. Whoop. Come on.
When was the last time this vault was accessed?
A goblin has been stationed at my desk for hundreds of years. In that time, no one has visited Vault 12. Until today.
What is that? Oh.
Vault 12.
Thank you for your help.
What was that? Here. 31. Coin? More? Ah, this is wonderful. After you, sir. You not?
What do you suppose we should be looking for?
I'm not sure.
Barely nothing.
Sir, I wonder if you might...
The instructions for Vault 12 indicate that I am to grant access to the holder of the key and then close the door.
Oh.
Wait!
What?
Best of luck.
Oh my god.
Professor?
That was certainly unexpected. Let me think.
Like a pet?
There must be something here. Revelio, perhaps.
Revelio?
Yes, a revealing charm. No time like the present. Let's see what we're missing, shall we? Ready your wand and focus. Move a bit closer and try again.
A door?
Well, that's a start. There's that symbol again. I don't suppose you see a way to...
I do, Professor. That symbol has the same glow as the one I saw in the portkey container.
Oh,
if what you can see reveals the way forward, then I dare say we are about to discover the secret of this vault. Lead the way.
Hop.
Lumos!
Oh.
This is no ordinary vault. I suspect we will need to earn our way out of here.
What do you mean, earn our way out? Do you think this is some sort of test?
I do. But to what end, I can't say. Stay close. There will be no disapparating if things go poorly. Not out of Gringotts.
Scary. Where are we going?
I see something up ahead.
What is it?
That glow again, but on the floor. The glow, it suddenly seemed as if the ground was swirling about.
Are you all right?
Yes, sir, I'm fine.
You seem to have caused the floor to change.
That statue.
What statue?
You can't
I see some sort of statue, but only as a reflection in the floor.
I presume this is what you saw reflected in the floor.
It is. The reflection's still there, but the statue's positions don't match. Wait. When you moved, the reflection turned in the direction of the light.
Oh.
Hmm. Perhaps you should cast Lumos.
How? Let's see. RT and Y.
Lumos.
Well done.
Now the reflection is turning towards me. It does follow the light.
Oh. So? What should I do?
Revelio. Lumos.
God.
Professor Fig! Professor, where are you?
Where did he go?
This isn't good. Where am I supposed to go?
Yeah. Where's this light?
What's happening? The wisps of magic seem to be leading me somewhere.
Is this the right way? Where should I go?
Oh, that's where they're leading me. That glow again. I'm on my own this time.
Oh.
Lumos.
Oh. Uh-oh.
It seems I have no choice.
Oh, like this?
I'm going to have to fight my part.
Oh. Whoa. He's ready. I press the button. I press the button.
Stupid one. close.
Whoa. Okay, so where should I go? This way?
Revelio.
Nothing. 53. And that's it. Oh, there. Yeah, 63. Have to touch this. Ooh-wee. Oh.
There you are. How did you... What is this place?
I don't know. But I found this, floating above that basin.
That is no mere basin. That is a pensieve for viewing memories. I wonder... Follow my lead.
All is in place.
The portkey is well hidden.
Perhaps too well. I wonder if the path we've created...
may be impossible to follow. It will only be impossible for one who cannot see traces of ancient magic as I can.
Your ability to see what others cannot will not be enough, Percival. We are entrusting the one who embarks on this path with powerful secrets, with knowledge others will do anything to obtain.
Yes, and if we are correct, Charles, the witch or wizard who completes the trials will have proven themselves worthy of that knowledge and the responsibility that accompanies it.
We've done all that we can.
Oh.
That's what you're seeing. The glow that surrounded them.
Yes, sir.
Astonishing.
Can I see magic?
Traces of an ancient magic, to be precise. The magic that Miriam had always believed existed, but could never... Miriam, and perhaps George, died in pursuit of knowledge that has been dormant for centuries. And you, it seems, are the key to understanding why. We were...
It all looks rather different than it did a moment ago.
Someone's coming.
Uh-oh.
Who were they?
I don't know. But, sir, you shouldn't be in here.
I was right.
Uh-oh.
Ranrock.
Seems my reputation precedes me.
I was beginning to think no one was ever going to visit Rackham's vault.
And why are you here?
No need for that. Just give me whatever it is you found here, and we can let bygones be bygones.
Sir, they have the key to the vault.
Oh my god.
Choose your next words wisely.
Bastard.
I only meant that the instructions to Vault 12 were quite clear. So? Sir, I must insist. I was to grant access only to one with the key, and you didn't have it.
I have no patience for traitors.
Uh-oh. I have to find this guy too?
Where were we?
I'm not giving you anything.
Well, perhaps your young friend here will be more helpful.
Whoa.
Are you all right?
Fine, sir.
Whew.
I've never seen so powerful a goblin. He seemed wholly unaffected by my magic.
Whoa. Then
where are we?
Where are we?
It can't be.
Can't be.
It seems those who set up the pensive, the locket, and the path to both wanted someone with your ability to end up here. Come. We have a sorting ceremony to get to.
Wow. I can't wait. Beautiful.
Oh, good. We haven't missed the sorting ceremony. I'm no expert, but that seems more appropriate.
Oh.
Now, I need to study this locket as soon as I can, but first I must contact the Ministry. They need to know what happened to George and be warned of Ranrock. For the moment, I ask that you keep all that's happened this evening between you and me.
Of course, sir.
Thank you. Ready for the sorting ceremony?
Something's wrong. Oh, I remember the head.
Phineas Nigellus Black. Prepare yourself to meet the headmaster.
Fig, nice of you to join us. The sorting ceremony's over.
There were...
What?
Complications.
Complications?
It seems the goblin problem
has... Goblins. I've no time for rumors, Fig, and I'm rapidly losing whatever patience I had left. If you're lucky, we might still be able to get you sorted this evening.
I'll be in touch.
Wow, look at the candles. Oh, I like the hairstyle.
Professor Weasley, we've one more to be sorted.
Sorry.
Welcome. You're just in time.
Great.
Have a seat.
Ah, yes. A bit older than the others, aren't you? You come here with preferences and preconceptions. Certain expectations.
Oh, here. Oh, I can't wait to start classes. I can't wait to explore. Explore where?
I'm looking forward to exploring Hogwarts and the world beyond the castle and grounds.
Indeed. Much can be gleaned by having an adventurous spirit. But your professors have a great deal to teach you as well. You're clever indeed. You have the ability to reflect clearly on that which puzzles others. And you've a ready mind, quick to learn. Perhaps you belong in Ravenclaw.
Ravenclaw. Should I accept this one or choose a different house? I don't know what's different. Should I accept? Okay, whatever.
You belong in Ravenclaw!
And one more thing.
I hate
Due to the unfortunate injury on the pitch in last spring's final, this year's Quidditch season has been cancelled. Enough! It's not as though I've banned flying altogether. But don't tempt me. You are here to focus on your academic futures. I'm sure you will have plenty to do before classes begin tomorrow. I said, I'm sure you all have plenty to do before classes begin tomorrow.
What do you mean? I don't know.
Quite an entrance. It's lovely to meet you. I'm...
Professor Weasley, would you be so kind as to show our new student to their common room?
I shall see to it, sir. As I was saying, I'm Professor Weasley. Pleased to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well, Professor.
As Deputy Headmistress, it is my distinct honor to show you to your common room. Right this way. It's quite uncommon for a student to begin as a fifth year. Might be a bit of a challenge, but one I'm sure you're up for.
I am, Professor.
This is the entrance to the Ravenclaw common room. You must solve a riddle to enter. I won't be of much help, I'm afraid. This sort of thing has always confounded me.
Who lived longer? The ghost or the poltergeist?
A ghost or a poltergeist? A non-being can never have been.
Uh-oh. That means what? Puzzles everywhere?
Well done. Now, go on in and get some sleep. You have a big day ahead of you tomorrow. Whoa. I shall be back in the morning to collect you for your first class.
Thank you, Professor Weasley.
You're welcome. I hope you enjoy your first night at Hogwarts. Sleep well.
Thank you, madame. Whoa.
Oh, looks like everyone's gone. Better head to the common room.
Oh, looks good. The 14? Okay. 14 meters? Something like that? Oh. I can't run, right? Huh? Oh.
This should be interesting.
I can't through here. Okay. Through the here, serve to. Oh, okay. This one first.
One moment. Watch this.
Uh-oh. Ugh.
What is this?
Someone threw a dung bomb.
Let's get out of here.
That's not nice.
That wasn't quite the reaction I wanted. Oh well.
What did you hope would happen?
I suppose I hoped it would lighten the mood. Ravenclaws can be a bit on edge the first day of class. I'm Everett, by the way. You seem downright calm next to some of these characters, and you survived a rather harrowing trip here.
I'm glad to be here, ready for classes to start.
Good. Glad to hear it. Truly, there's no reason to be nervous. Most professors are firm but fair. I mean, not all of the tricks I play are as simple as a tossed dung bomb, and I'm still here.
Wait, did you say most professors are firm but fair?
Ha, I did. But probably best I let you judge for yourself. I do tend to push their limits. I should wander off before someone traces that dung bomb back to me. Nice meeting you.
You too, Everett.
Done, two more. Okay, well done.
It must be different, starting Hogwarts in...
Not right either.
Hey, Steeple. Hello. Oh, I like your hair.
I want him to be in the perfect place. A place he'll be happy with. But I can't seem to find it. Great golden gobstones! I want him to thrive here.
Golden gobstones?
My own little expression. I bought this Dittany seedling from home, and I so want him to feel cozy. Dittany is amazing, isn't it? So much healing power in such a little plant. I've a bit of a thing for plants, as you can see. Pleased to meet you. I'm Samantha.
Nice to meet you, Samantha. Is Dittany used in Wiganwild potion?
It is. Looks like someone's been studying up on their potion making.
Actually, Professor Fig told me about Wiganwild potion.
Of course. I heard you were studying with him before term. He's an enigma, Fig. Teaches about theory, yet seems to know a lot about practical magic.
He did teach me a few things before term, but that's all I can tell you.
Well, I hope he told you about more than Wiganwild. You've lots to catch up on, I'm sure.
An affinity for herbology is more typical of a Hufflepuff than a Ravenclaw, isn't it?
Ordinarily, perhaps. But it runs in my family. We've a full plot of these little fellows back home. I suppose you could say herbology is in my roots.
Is it common practice for students to grow their own ingredients?
Oh, yes. Oh. In fact, our herbology teacher, Professor Garlick, encourages it. And I don't think Professor Sharp, our potions master, cares where you get your ingredients, as long as your brews are all perfect.
It was nice to meet you, Samantha. Good luck with your dittany.
Thank you. And good luck to you too on your first day.
Sweet girl. All right, next.
Last. Anyone been into Albie Weeks' shop lately? I'm always.
All right. Oh.
Deep breath.
The books.
Why, hello. Would you like to take a look?
Go ahead, go ahead.
Can't see too much in the day. Well, except for stars like Sirius, Canopus, Vega, and Arcturus. I'm Amit. Pleasure to have you in Ravenclaw. Never met someone who's been so close to a dragon before.
Can't say I recommend it, frankly. It's nice to meet you, Amit. I take it you like astronomy.
Oh, yes. So much to be learned from the stars. Also, there's something about the open air and night sky above the tower. It's invigorating. You will adore astronomy. Professor Shaw is incredibly knowledgeable.
I'm afraid I'm not much for memorizing constellations. Enough to worry about on the ground.
Well, you should know that all fifth years must take astronomy. However, I think you will feel differently after one night up on the tower. A quality telescope can show you things you never dreamed of.
I suppose I'll see you in class then.
Yes. Oh, and speaking of class, better get to my first one of the year. Nothing like the smell of fresh parchment, is there? Be seeing you!
Dan?
Hey there, new Ravenclaw. Professor Weasley is looking for you just outside. You would best not keep her waiting.
Here?
Can't imagine starting a new school this.
15 meters. Wow, the minimap, pretty useful. Hello.
Good morning. Good morning. Trust you're ready for your first day at Hogwarts?
I've been dreaming of this day for a long time. Can't believe I'm here.
Well, you are here. Make the most of it. You only have one first day at Hogwarts. Now, in light of your unique situation, joining us as a fifth year, you'll need to catch up with your classmates and not fall behind. Especially as you'll be expected to complete your OWLs at the end of the year.
OWLs?
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 Yes, your ordinary wizarding level exams. They will determine what type of career you can have when you leave here. After much discussion with the headmaster and the Department of Magical Education at the Ministry, we've devised something extraordinary to ensure your success.
Oh.
Here you are.
Whoa.
What is it?
It is a wizard's field guide. Oh. It will help you to keep track of what you are learning so that you master all that's expected of a fifth year. You would be wise to take full advantage of this exceptionally valuable resource.
Thank you, Professor, but what do you mean it will keep track of what I'm learning?
Perhaps seeing it in action will answer any questions you may have. Walk with me and we shall put it to the test.
Where?
This way. The guide will give you opportunities to practice your magic and educate yourself about wizarding lore.
Oh.
I certainly would have appreciated something like the field guide when I was a student. Why don't you cast Revelio on this bust? Oh. And see what details the field guide can provide.
Okay. Something.
Revelio.
Okay. Oh. Collect. Oh. Okay. Oh, what? Which button does? Oh, 1%. Huh? It's a vertical upgrade. So?
Clever, isn't it? Keep your eyes open for more opportunities like that, inside and outside of the castle.
Oh, the painting.
No time to waste. You've classes to attend.
Question mark? Oh.
Ah, good timing. Perfect opportunity to show you how to use flu flames to get around a bit quicker. Your field guide contains a map of the castle. Open it up and find Central Hall.
Oh, fast travel. Oh, good. Uh-huh. Huh? Oh, I see. Oh.
And here we are. Quite the time saver. These stairs lead directly to Central Hall.
Okay.
You can get almost anywhere in the castle quickly from Central Hall. Always something happening here. It's the heart of the hive. Our King's Cross Station, so to speak.
Showing off is a...
That should be all for now. You'll be expected to attend both Charms and Defense Against the Dark Arts classes today. And I'd like to be sure you get to Hogsmeade as soon as possible to replace the supplies you lost on the way here.
You mentioned Hogsmeade, Professor.
Hogsmeade is the only all-wizarding village in Britain, and is home to an array of shops and pubs. You should be able to find all of the school supplies you require in Hogsmeade.
Okay.
You will also, I imagine, enjoy many a butterbeer there with friends in due course.
Butterbeer?
Can you tell me more about the Defense Against the Dark Arts class?
Defense Against the Dark Arts, as the name implies, focuses on how to defend oneself against the evils that lurk beyond these walls. A mastery of Defense Against the Dark Arts is required for those who aspire to become aurors. Fortunately, we are lucky to have the ever-gifted Professor Hecate in charge of our students' education in that regard.
What will I learn in Charms class?
Exactly what you might expect. Spells, charms, jinxes, all terribly useful. I think you will enjoy Professor Ronan. He's a clever and entertaining wizard, and a talented teacher.
Thank you, Professor Weasley.
A lot to absorb on your first day, and you have much to learn. Happily, your professors have agreed to create additional assignments for you outside of class. You'll be up to speed in no time. Judging by your adept use of Revelio earlier, I'd say Professor Fig succeeded in at least showing you the basics.
He did, Professor.
He's been terribly vague as to the events preceding your arrival, specifically about what happened after that awful dragon attack. My suspicion is that there's more to the story than a search for belongings and an extended trip up to the castle.
Uh,
We did take a bit of a detour on the way here. Ended up exploring some ruins and... I shouldn't say more.
Exploring ruins? Well, I presume Professor Fig has his reasons for keeping the details to himself for now. Speak of the devil. Professor Fig, your ears must have been burning.
Oh?
Yes. You seem to have provided our new fifth year with a solid foundation in the basics of spellcasting.
Ah, I'm afraid I can't take all the credit there, Professor. They've a rare aptitude for magic, it seems.
Hmm. Well, I'm just glad you both arrived in one piece. Perfectly good boats and carriages to Hogwarts, and you chose to fly in the path of a dragon.
I wouldn't say I chose the dragon's path, Professor. Rather unfortunately, it would seem that it chose us.
Very well. Enough chit-chat. I need to get to class myself. Might I rely on you, Professor Fig, to explain the details of the field guide's map?
Of course.
Thank you. Good luck today. And remember to use your field guide. It will be invaluable to you. And invaluable to me, as I'll be using it to keep up to date on your progress.
Yes, Professor.
Come and find me in my classroom after you've attended both classes today, and I'll explain more about those assignments I mentioned. And we'll see if we can't get you to Hogsmeade for those supplies.
Okay, talk to Professor B.
It's good to see you, Professor.
And you. I was hoping our paths would cross today, before you immersed yourself in studies. Did I hear you and Professor Weasley talking about exploring ruins?
She caught me off guard. I didn't tell her anything else about our travels here. I will say, I think she suspects we're not being entirely forthcoming.
Yes, well, Professor Weasley is a brilliant and astute witch. It was right to keep the details to yourself for now. We don't know where this path we've embarked upon will lead. It may require a bit more flexibility with your time than she would approve of. And she may feel obliged to share details with the headmaster that would be better left between us.
Understood, Professor.
Good. Now, as capable as you are, I believe the ability you possess obliges you to be well-trained. Happily, you have the benefit of an exceptionally skilled team of witches and wizards to guide you. Speaking of guides, and so that I may avoid another not-so-subtle reproof from Professor Weasley, why don't I show you the clever enchantment we included in the field guide's map? Unfold it and have a look.
Oh, hold on. Huh?
The map is enchanted to help you find your way.
This will be incredibly helpful. Thank you.
Now, sounds like you've quite a day ahead, what with classes and a trip to Hogsmeade for supplies, including your own wand. You'll enjoy Mr. Ollivander. He's an exceptional craftsman and a good friend. I shall reach out when I have more information about our mysterious locket. For now, focus on your classes and pay attention. More than your owls may hinge on the magic you are able to master within these walls.
Oh, I have to go that way?
To prove me wrong.
Okay.
You saw that first year with the engorged head. That was me.
This cannot possibly be as difficult as it seems.
Whoa. I didn't know. Beautiful.
My family has a lineage of exemplary flyers. It's no one.
Huh?
Hello. I don't believe we've met.
Oh, hello. I'm Lenora. Pardon me if I seem a little distracted at the moment. Everyone thinks I'm utterly balmy. Samantha thinks I'm potty. But it's this painting. I never noticed it before. If I know Hogwarts, and I do, an empty frame doesn't appear for no reason. There's something more to this.
Are there other empty paintings like this around the school?
Yes, a few. Aww. This entire place is somewhat of a riddle, to be honest. If I can work out the riddle of this one, I'll know what to do with all of them. As good a place as any to begin.
Have you gained any insights about the painting since you've been studying it?
I did discover that casting Lumos has an effect of some kind. But I'm not sure what to do next.
If I have the time, I may look. Could be intriguing.
I've been racking my brains long enough. I hope you'll have better luck than I have. Do come and find me if you stumble on something illuminating that solves the mystery.
Lumos.
Oh?
That spot must be a clue. I should look around in case it's nearby.
Revelio.
Oh. Butterflies? Where is that down? How, this way? Can I? No, I can't. Hold on. That's a cat? Oh. Whoa. Interesting. Okay, just wanna open here. Okay, well, what is that?
Lumos.
Revelio. Lumos.
Hop. No?
Revelio.
I saw something.
Oh.
Now,
I have at home
far.
I can
yeah, better go back to there. Run!
Last week.
Huh? What is it?
This looks like the location from the painting. What could be so special about it?
What is that? Huh? What is this? Hold on. Oh. Let's see. Oh, the first one. Okay, what is this? Uh-huh. Is this okay? Let's see. 11, 21 and come on. The upper one. Oh, the third one. Huh? Stop. What is that? Oh. I have no idea. That's your third one. Three? Okay, I don't know what that is. I saw something.
Revelio.
Oh. Here?
You can't imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented flu powder.
Oh. Going up or down? Oh? Money? Uh-oh.
Revelio.
Nothing. Oh, you can't.
I think there were doxy eggs as well. But surely those would come.
Let's see. Uh-huh. Oh, okay. Only 1%. Complete. Oh. Collection? Do I have a... Ooh, here. Oh. What else? 00 inventory. Nothing. Gear. Oh. Ah. Oh, I see. Offense. One. Better than nothing. Let's see. Yeah, not bad. Oh. No. Do I have something? No way.
Revelio.
Yeah, what is this man? Not here? Oh. I saw something. Oh.
How nice to see you, my young friend.
Me?
Revelio.
Where is that? No. Oh? I saw something. Oh, the Caesar. Cat? Super cute. Aw. Super sweet. Oh. Okay, that's enough. Shong.
Revelio.
Oh. Everything unlocked. So I'm here.
Lumos.
Yeah, so.
Revelio.
Lumos.
Stay here, no?
No.
Huh?
Let's get you back to your frame, little moth.
Oh. Wow. Here? Okay, how? No, I didn't mean to do that.
I should tell Lenora that I solved the puzzle of that empty frame.
Wow. Well, that's good. How can I catch?
Wish I could sneak into the other common
rooms.
Just for an hour or so. Hogwarts is a second home to me.
Where is this?
Why would Slytherin put his common room in the dungeon?
Revelio!
Perhaps that's the point.
Awesome!
Never been to a
moth. Let's see. Okay. 2%. No. Not much. Oh, hold on. I saw something. Oh, this? This one's new. Right. Meh. Ah, okay. Charms class. Or defense against the dark arts class. Okay. So I think this might be fun. Not sure, but yeah, sure. But I cannot play. It's really fun. So far, I'm gonna say 10. No, too much. Anyway, it's really fun. Okay, so anyway, any break?
I wonder how we get it.
So how can I catch that one, the paper? Oh, here, hold on a second.
It's a
stone. Over here too?
Revelio.
Oh, okay. I have to figure this one out.
Lumos.
Hop.
Revelio.
No? Hop. Alright then. Okay, I have to figure this one out.
Weasley said she always found the door.
Video again. Interesting. Ah. Okay, I hope you guys enjoyed. Let me see your face. Don't be shy. Okay, I hope you guys enjoyed. That's it for today. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye.